श्री अब्दुल खलीक जी जी
सर्वेंट सर नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च प्लेस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द ओवरऑल रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फार्मास्यूटिकल सेक्टर इन द कंट्री एज एन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ नेशनल इम्पॉर्टेंस इट प्लेस एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट फॉर द इवर ग्रोइंग इंडियन फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्री हुज हैज बीन इन द फोर फ्रंट ऑफ India's science-based industries with wide-ranging capabilities in this important field of drug manufacture. More so, there is a greater need to pump in extra force in matters related to health and prepare ourselves for our future, especially after watching the present scenario of COVID-19. Sir, the move to accord the status of the Institute of National Importance to 6 of the 7 institutions by amending Section 22 of the Principal Act and the Clause 4.22 of the proposed bill is appreciated as this will enhance development and research work in each of the institute. NIPA Mohali already enjoy the status. Hope this will bring clarity on the status of all the institutes. The proposed bill makes way for any similar institutes set up subsequently to be Institute of National Importance automatically. Sir, Section 4.3 of the Principal Act and Clause 6 of the proposed bill has brought drastic change in the composition of the Board of Governors of the institutes. Number of members of the board has been brought down from 23 to 12 members. In the process, 3 eminent public persons and 3 of the member of parliaments, 2 from Lok Sabha and 1 from Raj Sabha, have been removed among others. Eminent public persons and MPs as people representatives can provide better insight to any institutional body as they are connected to the public at large than anyone else. MPs also act as representative of the parliament and may arise any important issues that need immediate government intervention. Government must consider having both the categories in the board, even if it means downsizing in number from 3 each. Sudden downsizing of the board to close 50% and a total overhaul in the composition might give knee-jerk reactions. Hope the government has taken into consideration. Would like to recommend that a chairman of the board of the governor should be a person who is highly qualified in pharmacology and holds no other qualification. Sir, clause 30A, one of the proposed act, talks about the establishment of the council, which will act as central body of the, all the 7 put together. There is a need to increase the number of field experts in the councils. Doing so would ensure planned and coordinated development of the pharmaceutical education and research and maintenance of the standard across institutes. The bill also proposes that the council should meet once in a year. However, to nurture the growth and development of the institute of the national importance, the council should meet more than once in a year. 1 year time is too long. To big a time. Meeting of the council should be held once in every 4 or 6 months. But what is very imminent, the government, through the proposed amendment, is trying to make cosmetic change of the institutes. However, there is not much of an effort to create more opportunities for work in pharmaceutical research. In a country like ours, with a huge population, and not so good healthcare facilities available to its citizens, there is huge need for research and development in health-related sector. And to bridge the gap, there is a need to establish more such institutions throughout the country. The present government, during its first term, had announced establishment of new NIPAR in Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and Chhattisgarh. However, for reasons known to the government, the announcement is still on papers and nothing concrete has been done yet. We need to pull our socks and bite the dust if we want to develop the quality of our research. Sitting on announcement looking for opportunities, time will do no good for the country. Thank you, sir.